you know, and I sat down at the table, and I wasn't there too long, and somebody tapped me on my arm, and I turned around. It was Michael.
Hi, Ernie.
I said, hey, Mike, how you doing, man?
Is it all right if I sit down?
I said, yeah, man, come on, sit down, ain't no thing. And we sat there for a little bit, and he said,
Ernie, do you think you could introduce me to your brother, Ronald?
I said, come on, Michael. He knows you, you know him. Okay. You know, he's not going to bite you or nothing like that.
Mm. Yeah, but he might be busy thinking about something.
I said, okay, I'm going to go over and ask him. So it's like something out The Godfather.
Right.
So I walk over to my brother, and I say, Michael Jackson wants to come over and sit at the table with you. Is it all right? Ronald says, it's all right.
All right, y'all, so the Isley Brothers appeared on the Drink Champs. You know what I'm saying? I can't even front, though. Like, when I saw the Drink Champs advertise this episode, you feel me? I was like, oh, shit, I can't wait to see this shit. Drink Champs, they gonna break that shit down. They gonna give you a good, in-depth, 2-3 hour interview, you feel me? Oh shit, hold shit, I'm rushing. I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Nuncy, locked in the Nuncy's Television Studios Corporation Production Network Incorporated, Inc. Thank you for being here. We about to talk about this whole Lovers Quarrel, this musical saga between Robert Kelly and the Isley Brothers, you feel me? Specifically, Mr. Biggs. This is Mr. Biggs. How you doing, Mr. Biggs? But yo, we about to get into that shit, yo, because, you know what I'm saying, while I was watching the Isley Brothers on the Drink Champs, you know what I'm saying, I was wondering if they was going to talk about old Robert, you feel me? I wonder if Robert's name going to come up in the conversation.
That's one of the important parts of our show. Right. Every night.
Yeah. Mm. Right.
Every night, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And Download, you know. Me and R. Kelly did Download video, was one of the first video that we took 3 or 4 days to do.
Hype Williams, right?
Hype Williams.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And that was one of the great videos. Mm. At the time, R. Kelly, I guess the problems had started. Mm. But if you go back and look at that video, that has to be one of the greatest hip-hop videos.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This was so...
I would like to say...
Yeah, please. Yeah.
R. Kelly is one of the greatest producer writers mm-hmm. that we have.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
You know... we didn't keep up with what he did.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He was always a gentleman with us.
Right. He was his host.
You could only speak on what you were dealing with.
You're correct.
Right.
Yes.
I wonder if Robert's name is going to come up in the conversation. Because that was my introduction. Well, it wasn't my introduction, but it was a great-ass rebranding, you feel me, for the Isley Brothers, for Run Isley. For this whole Mr. Biggs character, you feel me? Cause I remember being in like the sixth grade singing this shit, you feel me? On the school bus, you feel me? Like we lit as hell. Contagious, you feel me? We about to get into all of that because they got like 4 songs that really stood out to me while I was thinking about this whole musical saga between Mr. Biggs and R. Kelly. We about to talk about Down Low.
Frank, are you ready to go yet?
I'll be with you in, say, a half a minute. Okay. Kelly, I don't have to tell you. You know Lila means everything to me.
I understand that, Mr. Biggs. Now.
We're about to talk about a friend of mine, The Remix. The Remix.
This is Mr. Biggs.
How you doing, Mr. Biggs?
We're about to talk about Contagious. And we're going to talk about Busted.
Baby, didn't you get my two-way? I was with my girlfriend.
You a lie.
But But let's talk about it, because R. Kelly, he started out working security, you feel me? And Ron went out of town. Ron was like, you feel me, don't touch my woman, you feel me? R. Kelly slept with his wife. Ron took them out in the desert. I'm sorry, Mr. Biggs took them out in the desert. He beat them down. Shoot, they beat the woman so bad as a result to her injuries that she received during the beatdown, you feel me? She passed away. The lovely Garcelle Bouvois. I can't really pronounce that. What's how you pronounce that, y'all? Bouvius. Garcelle Bouvius.
Kelly, keep it rolling.
So, okay, so you think about it. Part two, Friend of Mine, the remix. Now Kelly is back with this man's daughter, you feel me? Like, this nigga done almost killed you, man. And now you gonna come back and sleep with his daughter. That's why I feel like they should've made this into, like, some type of movie. You know what I'm saying? Like a Jordan Peele, cause he gonna give it that, you know what I'm saying? That, like a psychological, cause it would have to be a psychological thriller, cause Something gotta be wrong in your head, you feel me, for you to be back in this man's life. This time you messing with his daughter, you feel me? Cause Ron was like, call him, baby. She's like, I don't wanna. She's like, I don't wanna. Call him, baby. Call him right now. Call him. Oh, she didn't want to call, no. She didn't want to call. She didn't want to make that call, no. Come on, no. Now, I say, we have to be like a psychological thriller, you feel me? Get Tyler Perry to get in there with it, make it a little dramatic. He gonna give it that good dramatic, you feel me? How you doing, Mr. Biggs? What you mean is going on? Come on, now, that shit was bad, no. And cause I don't even think he realized. I don't think Mr. Biggs realizing who he talking to. He don't even realize it's that same man. You feel me? Like this nigga is back. You feel me?
Kelly's telling me that you're sleeping with another woman.
Just because you see me with her doesn't mean I'm creeping. And if you're not sleeping with her, what the hell you doing with her? Come on, now that shit was bad. No. Then we fast forward to Contagious. Like I say, Contagious, now that's really the one that probably stood out. Cause I say, I can really remember singing that shit on the school bus. You're contagious, touch me, baby. Give me what you got, then a man said. I used to like that part right there. Then a man said. And just think about it, y'all, because this is like the third song in the musical Saga, in this whole Lovers Quarrel. This is probably like the third track, you feel me? And you gotta talk about the character development of Mr. Biggs, because at this point in his life, he just let them leave, you feel me? And you know what I'm saying? We think back in like part one, well, in the down low, he took him out in the desert and he beat him down, you feel me? That's character development, you feel me? Come on now. And then we get to Busted. Now, I used to like this shit, now. But baby, did you get my two-way? I was with my girlfriend, you were alive. And shout out to her homegirls, cause her homegirls, you feel me? They want her real rollies, you feel me? They want her real rollies, cause they ain't even look out for it. They was like, hell no, I ain't seen her, you feel?
They're like, no, she haven't been over here. They're like, no.
Billy, I think one or two. Say yes, no, that's one thing I gotta know. Bust it. Go ahead, Ernie. Ernie was playing that guitar, dog. Shout out to Ernie, now. Ernie be playing that shit, dog. All right, y'all, so I actually forgot to mention the showdown. I forgot to mention the showdown, you know what I'm saying? Part five of this whole music saga, teratology, trilogy, you feel me? Yeah, showdown. And this is where they actually address all the drama and the beef. And R. Kelly admits, like, the reason I've been terrorizing you is because you killed Lala back in 1998, now. Garcelle Beauvoir. Well, like I said, y'all, I'm Nootsy, and we just talking about how long it been took. Okay, that's, you know what I'm saying? I did a little something, you feel me? I just want to talk about the whole Lovers Quarrel, you feel me? Mr. Biggs, R. Kelly, you feel me? This whole psychological thriller. Hollywood need to get with me, you feel me? I got some plans, I got some thoughts, I got some ideas. You know what I'm saying? It would have to be a little bit of Jordan Peele. I would like for it to be like a psychological thriller, because to experience something so traumatic as, you feel me, as what he did in the down low, and to come back and to be with his daughter, and then to come back again, you feel me? Just, you feel me? That's something psychological. But then at the same time, you would need like a little Tyler Perry to get a little, cause Tyler, he gonna make it dramatic and drama now. Tyler gonna do some drama now. You gonna be like, oh shit, now that was sad. But yeah, like I said, y'all, Drink Challenge, y'all need to check out that episode, you feel me? Great episode. I'm Nootsy, locked in the Nootsy's Television Studios Corporation Production Network Incorporated Inc. You know what I'm saying? I got this bun looking a mess. But I'm finished now, so it's, if it's up, then it's stuck. It's gonna have to be up here. I'm out, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Get in the comment section, like, comment, and subscribe. You feel me? Let's talk, let's chat, you feel me? And I'm out, y'all.